Whenever I talk about the night sky, just remember that we're always talking about the northern hemisphere. So this is the view of the sky north of the equator. And what even makes it even more sort of adapted to where we live, it's not even sort of a little bit north of the equator. It's sort of up quite far north of the equator, maybe to latitudes of 30, 35, 40 degrees, something like that. That's the northern latitude you need to be in to see, easily see the Big Dipper and all the things that we've been talking about. So the question always comes up, well, what about in the southern sky? What if I'm south of the equator? What about down there? Like, is there a south star? And the answer to the question to that is there is no south star. So this nice beacon that we have called Polaris that always tells us where north is and gives us an idea of what's going on, there is no such thing in the southern hemisphere like that. What they do have down there is something called the Southern Cross. So you would look for that, which sort of looks like a cross on the side like that. And then there's two other stars called the pointers right here. Nothing like the pointer stars on the Big Dipper, but that's what they're called down there nonetheless. And there's a star out here called Archinor, which is relatively easy to see as well. And sort of in your mind, you have to let these lines cross. Like you have to imagine a line going from the so-called pointers directly to Archinor. Then you just sort of have to take on that long axis of the Southern Cross, let that line imaginary in your mind go across like that. And right where they intersect, that is about due south. So there is no star there. There is no star there to be seen. No little white dot, anything like that. There's nothing that everything revolves around or anything. But you just sort of have to take our word for it that you take a line across the Southern Cross like that, connect the pointers with Archinor, and right there will be the southern direction of south. And that's about all they have in the southern hemisphere for either navigation or just to conclude then, make sure you also know that our discussion here of the southern hemisphere and the fact that there is a lack of a south star also gives you at least a partial answer to question number 46. 46 says, we know the North Star points north. And part one says, is there an east-west beacon in the sky? We'll talk about that soon. Then the last part of the question says, what about a south star? So you should definitely have the answer to that, yeah? Turning south. And it is that Southern Cross which forms the stars on the Australian flag. You can sort of see the Southern Cross right in there. And the other interesting part that you see, if you can ever get south of the equator like that, is you see these Magellanic clouds. I don't know exactly what they are. They're kind of like dwarf galaxies, but they're very clear to see. I think they're galaxies that never quite formed, or they're smaller, getting larger, or something like that. And they're called Magellanic because it was Ferdinand Magellan who first saw these when he sailed south of the equator and reported back for the first time about what he saw in the southern sky. A couple of dwarf galaxies there. So that's about it for what you would see in the southern sky. There's lots more, but that's about all I'll say about it.